Hey, this is Presh Talwalkar. A standard dice has the numbers 1 to 6, each appearing with the probability of 1/6. If the dice is modified so the number 6 appears with half the frequency of the other numbers, what is the new probability of rolling a 6? I want to mention I came across this problem in a new book, Power Up by Matthew Lane. The book uses video games to discuss really interesting mathematical concepts, and I learned quite a few new things. I did receive a free advanced copy of the book for review, and it's really a great book. You should check it out. There's a link in the video description. So returning to the problem, can you figure it out? Give this problem a try, and when you're ready, keep watching the video for the solution. In a standard dice, the probability of rolling a 6 is equal to 1/6, which is the same as rolling any other number. In this loaded dice, we want the probability of 6 to equal half the probability of rolling any other number. So one way you might think about solving the problem is that you might simply decrease the probability in half. That is, you would say the probability of rolling a 6 will be 1/2 times 1/6, which equals 1/12. But there's a problem when you do this. If you add up all the other sides, which still have a probability of 1/6, then the total probability will be too small. It will not add up to 1. You will actually get that the probability of these numbers will be equal to 11 over 12. So this is the wrong answer because we need the sum of all the probabilities to be equal to 1. But no worries, there's a way to fix this. Since we need the probability to be 1, we can scale each term by 12 over 11. This is so that we have 11 over 12 being equal to 1 once we scale it, and if we scale all the other terms by the same factor, we'll get the correct probability. So 12 over 11 times 1 over 12 is equal to 1 over 11, and 12 over 11 times 1 over 6 is equal to 2 over 11. And when we sum these new probabilities, we do in fact get that the total probability is equal to 1. So this is the correct answer. The probability of rolling a 6 will be equal to 1 over 11. But the lesson here is that you can't simply adjust one probability. If you decrease the probability of rolling a 6, you have to compensate by adjusting all the other probabilities. There's another way you could have come up with this answer. Let's suppose P is equal to the probability of rolling a 6. We then have the probability of rolling any other number will be equal to 2P. Now we need the total probability of all the rolls to be equal to 1. So we can algebraically add up these variables. We have 1 term of P and 5 terms of 2P to be equal to 1. This will be a total of 11p that's equal to 1, which means p is equal to 1 over 11. So we get to the same answer, but it was done in an algebraic way rather than scaling up the probabilities and adjusting. There's another way you could have solved this problem. You could have also thought about the odds of the rolls, or the relative probabilities. So the odds of rolling a 6 will be 2 to 1 against rolling a 6. It'll be twice as likely to roll any other number than rolling a 6. Now, in order to convert these odds into probabilities, what we do is we add up all of these numbers. We have 1 for the 6, and we have 5 terms of 2. This will be equal to 11. In order to convert these odds into probabilities, we divide each of the relative odds by 11. So we again get to the same answer, that the probability of rolling a 6 is equal to 1 divided by 11. Did you figure out this problem? And which method did you use? Thanks for watching this video. Please subscribe to my channel. I make videos on math and game theory. You can catch me on my blog, Mind Your Decisions, which you can follow on Facebook, Google+, and Patreon. You can catch me on social media at Presh Talwalkar. And if you like this video, please check out my books. There are links in the video description.